Welcome everybody to another video. Today I'm pretty excited to showcase to you guys Infinite Blue, because this game is being developed by a well-known dev called Gluten Free Games. If you don't know Gluten Free Games, he basically did mobile games and he also did a game called The Wilds, which you guys probably have watched in my channel and a lot of you probably enjoy. Now he jumped from Unity to Unreal Engine 5 and decide to make Infinite Blue. So this is his first project on Unreal Engine, and we are here to take a deep dive on his game. Now, keep in mind that this is a very, very early game because it got launched like a few days ago. So there's a lot of bugs, a lot of things that you guys need to expect, but it is a free-to-play game and you guys can download it right now on Steam. I'm gonna leave the link down in the description below so you guys can try for yourselves. But we're gonna try here ourselves a little dolphin and see how things will go. So here we are on the Red Reef. We can play currently as a dolphin, but we can also possess other animals by right-clicking and pressing F. We can kind of switch to the orca. If you want to play as one of these bigger animals, you can't really play them. You can only play as a small fish, which I don't really understand. We do have a compass on the top left. We have our stamina, maybe food. And of course, we can go up here to the top of the water and take a peek. A cool thing is that we have a map, and you can see that this is a pretty big map. We have the Abyss, Red Reef, Jagger Cove, Alp Forest, and a lot of different types of things. Now, for now, I don't really know the purpose of this game, because in the wilds you couldn't really do a lot, but you can definitely grow and you could make a family. In Infinite Blue, I am really unaware of what you can and cannot do. As of right now, I will say this, there is not really any purpose besides killing and maybe swim around. You can do these awesome cool jumps by pressing space, and you can see that there is a world record for the highest jump that we will try and see if we can achieve. Maybe not. Maybe we need a dolphin for this. But there might be a lot of species depending on the area, which I'm pretty curious to see. And I don't really know if water animal survival games is something that you guys enjoy, or if it's something that you guys want to see so that you can play as your favorite aquatic animal, because there is for now no game that allows you to play as an orca or a shark. For now, you only have the dinosaur games and the typical African games. And we are currently playing on Ultra, and I can't really say that the game looks gorgeous. It looks okay, but for some reason it looks low quality, but as we have to expect from a free-to-play game. Not to be mean to our friend Gluten-Free, but for now, I think the only thing that we can actually do is attack and eat. Which, the animations are still a work in progress, as you guys can see. It is slightly different from the wilds, but it still has the same concept, but it still needs a few tweaks, a few updates and bug fixes and improvements, of course. But if you're one of these enthusiasts who likes water animal and water creatures, I think you will enjoy Infinite Blue. We basically got one shot. Now that we died, our body or our spirit gets transferred to a next animal, which I do think that the damage output needs to be adjusted. Now, I see that we have levels, so that's why I probably got killed. If you press C, you can see the stats, the length, the weight, the growth stage, and of course the vitals, oxygen and hunger. You have the quick description of the saw shark, and of course your diet, which I think it will depend and change from animal to animal. But I do want to play as a great white. Because these animals in South Africa are really, really nasty. And they are also one of my favorite. I do prefer the orca, but I do also like the great white shark. It looks pretty neat. Pretty beautiful. I do want to see if you can do a big dive. Having watched Jaws when I was a little kid, it's something that I do really enjoy playing as a shark. Although they're not really that strong when it comes to fighting orcas. Pretty funny that it kind of locks into place when you right click. But it's still the combat still needs a little bit of tweaking. I do prefer the wild combat, but we are still a 22 senior. Only know if we can fight a dolphin, because we don't really want to get killed by one. But the model itself looks pretty nice, I have to say. I don't know if you can mate, or if you can invite other sharks to your group like you can do in the wilds. It seems to be not implemented yet, but I do want to go into the abyss. See how things are. I know that it might sound a little bit cliche, but every single game that involves oceans, there are always shipwrecks, which I'm totally aboard with. Do love to explore, deep dive in the ocean, but there are people who are scared of the ocean when it comes to not swimming, but how deep it can be. There's a name for that. But it looks pretty nice. Although we were playing on Ultra, I was expecting a little bit more of quality when it comes to Unreal Engine. And I don't really know why, but we are swimming pretty slowly. I thought that I clicked a button accidentally that enabled our swimming speed or something, but I think there is none. So this is the normal speed of the great white shark. And things randomly start to spawn as we swim, which is something that Gluten needs to fix. But below us is the abyss. I'm gonna take a look to see what type of fish we can find. Now, a cool thing that he could do is the more deep you go, the darker it becomes. Just like in real life. And you could see different types of animals, those who live in darkness, as well as one of those fishes that has kind of like a lantern on his face that is pretty ugly, which I don't really know his name in English, but that would also add to a little bit of realism and immersion. Because even though we are in the abyss, we still have some light piercing through. Well, funny enough, we died of starvation. I wasn't really paying attention to the HUD. It doesn't really give you the details. You can see that you have a HUD on the bottom left, but you can't really tell which one is food, which one is O2. And it kind of goes by you without you noticing that you need to eat. Maybe because I'm more focused in exploring, but... if he could implement something or bigger HUD that can give you a better information. There we go. Can we eat? Oh, we can tear by shaking, I think. We can grab onto stuff, but we seem to be having a little bit of a problem, so we're gonna try and find a bigger fish. Try on this great white. It is not a great white. The mackerel shark. Okay, now he's dead. When you grab them, they kind of go into a ragdoll stage, which you think they're dead, but they're not really dead. And my question is, how can we eat? Because I think we need to tear it. Oh, there we go. We have taken one meat. So there is this membering. So there might be like a hitbox problem. Now we are fully grown. We don't really have to worry about the starvation problems. And just because we can, I do want to try and play as a humpback whale. Now, I do want to try and see a diet, which is shrimp. And I think we need to go to the surface to replenish our oxygen. Not really sure, but we have to keep an eye on that. But we do have to try and find some shrimp. And I have to say that certain animals should spawn at certain places, because for a humpback whale or even, you know, a blue whale or a sperm whale, this type of environment is a little bit small for the animal that they are. Now, this is just me talking about realism. Usually you won't really see them in this type of environment. You would see them basically in deep ocean. And I do want to see how the dive is. It's not really as we expected, as in real life, but hopefully he will add a pretty magnificent animation. You can see the different in size. Oh, that might be shrimp. Yeah, these are shrimps. There we go. We are almost at full. There we go. It's just pretty sad that we can't really do like a jump and spin at the surface like they do. Or even, for example, slam their tails like they do in some instance in real life. I'm just gonna hold spacebar. Because I don't think we need to press shift. I think we only need to hold spacebar. If you play Infinite Blue, leave down in the comments below what is your jumping high record and which animal you did that. Because if you do a dolphin, you know, it's gonna be different from doing as a whale. It seems like it gets more... But, yeah, there's still a few things to be fixed. Hopefully you guys enjoy Infinite Blue. Please go check it out on Steam. Everything will be down in the description below so you guys can go and play. Yet again, this game is a free-to-play game and unfortunately is for PC only. And hopefully he can do maybe Infinite Blue for mobile, because I know that he did mobile games. So let's pray. But for now, this is a PC only free-to-play game on Steam, and you guys can go and try it for yourselves right now. So thank you very much for watching. Kato here. I'll catch you guys in a next video. Take care and peace.